philosophy is that I like to find those fields that are the just beginning. They've just been plowed, or they've been just cultivated, or the harvest has taken place, or it's just beginning, something like that, where you can actually see the earth and how man has gone in and cultivated that land to make it produce something, you know, that we can all participate in, you know. I guess my painting career actually started in high school, even before I was painting, but I actually was making a living in high school painting landscapes. So I had a pretty good little business going, and from that point, it was, what are you gonna do with your life, really? I mean, nobody makes a living in art, so how are you gonna make a living? So I decided probably at that point, it was the only way you can do it would be to go to college and get a degree and teach. So that was the goal. The closer I got to the end of my college career, I realized that I wanted to really give it a shot out there in the world to see if it's possible to make a living with it. Your perspective changes a lot with age. You know, there's when I started, it was I wanted to get in good galleries. I wanted my work to be represented in the best ways, in the best light, and I had really no role models, anyone to really show how that was done. It was a time in Utah when I think there maybe was one or two galleries in Utah. It was all. And there was no one that was really making it in a real professional type of way. So myself and a lot of my friends were kind of pioneers along that way in trying to find a way to sell your work. So, you know, through perseverance and everything over the years, it's been, it's brought me to learn from my successes and failures. And my failure, you tend to learn more from your failures than you do your successes. And I learned that there's two things that will really put an artist, give the artist recognition and put you on the map as being a serious artist, and that is, number one is probably your insight and the originality of your work, and have it be technically as good as you can actually ever possibly make it. Use history to kind of help you judge those things by, not so much as what's popular, what's happening out there in the art world today. Those are pretty fleeting, and develop your own insight into how you produce your work. I guess we could say the end, if you want to call it that. I hope to be 95, sitting here in my chair as a skeleton when someone finds me up. That's kind of what will happen. But what can you do with your time and your life to make it meaningful, to make it some of the most meaningful times? Because with years and years of experience in the art world, in the financial markets, and as well as in the creative side of what you do and what you want to do, it's what can I do that will kind of bring this all back around and feel like you have given something of yourself and your talent and your ability to the world of art. Aesthetics is very, very important to me. The quality of a piece of work is very, very important to me. I'm producing less art today, but I'm putting more time into it. And that time I'm trying to make more meaningful. A painting like this used to take me a couple of days. I'm now putting more time into it. Not that it's making it better, I don't even know if it's making it better. It's just that I'm trying to refine my imagery more so, to where I'm feeling better about it and feel like I'm going to give the very best of what I have toward the end. Now, many times artists in the end, in their later works, don't necessarily represent their best works. You know, maybe we tend to lose it a little as we go along too, but I think if you have the right values and the right perspective on who you are and what you want to do with it, you make the best of it. You make the best of it, and you put the best time into it, and toward the end, you put your best time into it. I don't know of any very successful artist that ever gave it up when they were 50. It's this obsession that we have. It's a creative obsession. I always call it my pilot light. It's always flickering there. It never goes out. It burns brighter on Monday mornings because I got the weekend out of the way. I don't have to worry about that anymore. I can get back in the studio again. So that's the way my life has always been. And that's kind of the way I want to go out. It's just to say he did his best to produce the best body of work.